This is part one of our audiovisual content creation series, USB microphones. We're going to be looking at two basically. There are two types of microphones, dynamic and condenser, and we're going to look at each of them. The dynamic microphone is basically a metal plate connected to a coil that has a magnet going through it, and as you talk and as the music plays, air pressure moves that diaphragm back and forth, and that coil and the magnet generate electricity, an electromagnetic wave that parallels the sound wave. So you get an electrical wave that represents the sound wave. In the case of a condenser mic, it needs an outside power supply that comes from either your USB, your mixing board, or your preamp in the form of what's called 48 volt phantom power. Or if it's a really cheap condenser mic, it has a AA battery inside of it, and that's what powers it. And there's a small circuit inside the condenser mic that preamplifies and generates the proper voltage to the system. And there is a fragile diaphragm, and this can be plastic mylar, it can be metal, it can be aluminum, it can be aluminized. In the case of the $5,000 to $25,000 microphones, it is usually a 5-micron mylar gold sputtered diaphragm that is connected to a backplate. Sometimes there are two for stereo. So a second diaphragm, you see the small little line here, that's the diaphragm. Sometimes there's a second one behind it so that it can record in stereo. Electricity is put through both plates, and as sound moves, the diaphragm changes the potential of power between the two plates. And this is sometimes called capacitance. So the condenser microphone has a more fragile diaphragm, usually vertical, whereas the dynamic microphones are usually horizontal and cylindrical, although they can be held vertically. There are also several connectors. On the bottom left here, you see this circular silver connector that is always used for either line in. It can be a mini plug, which is 1/8 inch. It can be a phone plug, which is 1/4 inch. That's for like stereo. That's for like headphones, left and right. It can be either TS or TRS. These are either mono or stereo. The big one there at the top is the XLR with 3 connectors. That's used for mixing boards and preamps. The one we're going to be dealing with today is the one on the lower right, which is the USB connector. And we're going to be dealing with mics that connect directly to your computer. And the entry-level mic that everybody uses is the Blue Yeti. It's priced around $100. With some extra bells and whistles, it's closer to $160. Yes, you will find USB mics priced between $25 and $500. This is the one most people use. It's the one everybody raves about. I've heard it. It's a little on the transparent side, but it works. And it's affordable. It goes directly into your computer, and all you need is recording software, which you can sometimes get for free, or you can buy software from a company like NCH, Cubase, Pro Tool. We can step up a bit, and we have this microphone, and this is the one you will see most YouTubers use. It's also the one a lot of radio people use, and it's the Shure MV7USB, and it's a dynamic mic. This is the one with the metal plate and the magnet and the coil. Doesn't have all the fancy high-end or low-end that the Blue Yeti has. This one is 50 hertz to 16,000, which is still within the range of the human voice. This one will not record violins as well. This one will not record acoustic guitar as well as a condenser mic. But it is sturdier, it is heavier. You can drop this and it usually doesn't hurt it, but I wouldn't recommend it. And as you can see there, it swivels within that U base. And you connect this to the spring arm desk mic stand or the floor mic boom stand, which is something else you should see about getting for both types of microphones. And these are priced from $20 to $150. The 150 ones are far more heavy duty. They don't topple over. They have a counterweight on the back. They aren't flimsy. They will last you forever. The $20 one is the one I've got. It shakes, rattles, and rolls, but it does the job. I will not cry when it breaks. I will simply go buy another $20 one, or maybe I'll spend a little bit more and get a $40 or $50 one. You also need a pop filter or spit screen. This fragile diaphragm in the condenser microphone loses its upper end if spit gets on it. This also will limit the P sounds that pop, pop, and make your microphone go pop, 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 pop. The foam windscreen helps too. Foam windscreen. On my microphone, I've got a cotton sock and a pop filter, and that helps a lot. Here we have the situation in which for $100 and some recording software, you can do YouTubing, TikToking, video blogging, maybe make a book trailer, maybe even do an audio book. You can do podcasting. Interviewing, that requires more equipment. That requires a preamp, a mixing board, and more microphones, and more mic stands. You're not going to be able to do interviewing with just one microphone. So this is our first look at microphones. And if you're interested in learning more, you can pick up my book, Audio and Recording for Everyone. The Kindle and Nook edition is $4.99. Got lots of pictures. It's got a buyer's guide. The trade publication print book is $13. They're both available everywhere. This series, however, is going to cover most of what's in that book, and you'll get it for free. You just get it a week at a time as I do the series. In the United States, you can find a lot of this equipment that I'm talking about from Adorama Camera, Amazon, Best Buy, BH Photo, Guitar Center, Musician's Friend, Sweetwater, Walmart, ZZ Sounds, Woodwind Brasswind. Sometimes you can also find them at your local music dealer. If you found this program informative, give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Here, I discuss the nuts and bolts of writing and publishing, editing, cover creation, copyrights, picking a self-publisher, making a website, putting books into stores, how to get your manuscript before agents and publishers, and I add new content all the time. So have a good writing day.